Welcome to tutorialsinhand.com. In this video tutorial, we are going to learn how to write Java program to find a student's grade using if-else ladder. Now for that, we are going to use this chart on the right side of the screen where it is given if the mark is greater than is equals to 90, the student belongs to grade A. If the marks is within the range of 90 to 80, then the grade is B and so on. So you can refer this chart. So we are going to follow this chart for the time being, and we have already accepted the user input mark from the console using scanner. The explanation to the scanner is given in a separate video tutorial. You can find the link in the description if you are not aware how to accept user input in Java. Okay, so let's proceed to write the logic. So you can see that there is a set of conditions based on which certain grade is provided. So if we consider this first one, if the marks is greater than is equals to 90. So this is a condition, and this condition will go within the if, right? If we write over here if, and then within bracket we close this marks greater than is equals to 90, so this becomes one condition, and then we will have curly braces, and within curly braces we will print the grade is A, right? And then once we close that curly brace, we are going to have another if else block within which the condition should be this one, right? And then once this condition satisfied, within this if else body we will print this grade, and then again we will write another if else statement, and within that we will have this condition, and then within the body if it satisfies, then this grade would be printed, and this would follow on till the marks is less than 40. So let's begin with the first criteria. Now the first criteria says that if marks is greater than is equals to 90, that means if the mark is greater than is equals to 90, so we already have got our marks from the console that user will input. So we will write if mark, press control tab, you will get the suggestion, and then greater than is equals to 90, then what we are going to print? We are going to print that, write sysO control tab, you get suggestion, and within that just print, you can simply copy it from here, the grade is excellent A, and we have got the first condition. So the mark that is entered, if it is greater than is equals to 90, then we will print the grade of the student as A. The more appropriate would be grade A, right? Now this is only one condition. We have got several other conditions as well. So now the other condition is between the range of 90 to 80, including 80, which is even if it is equals to 80, then also this grade would only be considered. So how we are going to write this logic? So we are going to write this logic as shown over here. Now we will have another else if block, right? And within the else if, the another condition is going to be this one, that is mark should be less than 90 but greater than is equals to 80, then it should be considered as grade B. Let's write the condition. The mark is now less than 90, right? The mark should be less than 90 and it should be greater than is equals to 80. So we will have this and mark greater than is equals to 80. So this is the another condition that we have got for this one. Now, between the range of 90 to 80 we have written, that means if marks is less than 90 and marks is greater than is equals to 80, that means 80 is also included. If you give 80, then also it will satisfy this criteria, and whatever is written within this will get printed on the screen. So now the grade is B, right? When B is very good. So this is another condition. Now I think you already have sensed that how you are going to have this ladder written in your code, right? The next condition is between 80 to 70, including 70. So another else if block is required, right? Else if, and within this give condition. Now the condition is less than 80 but greater than is equals to 70, right? Again mark less than 80 and why we are writing and? Because both the criteria should satisfy. That means the mark should be less than 80 but it should be greater than 70, that means greater than is equals to 70, right? And then it will belong to the grade C, right? Now again we can simply paste it, we can write grade C see good. So we have also got the range of 80 to 70, right? Then we have the range from 70 to 60, including 60. Now your task becomes very simple. You can simply copy and paste this. Once you are well acquainted with the logic, you can simply copy and paste and save your time. And now you know that it should be less than 70 and what greater than is equals to 60. So just replace it with greater than is equals to 60 and then replace the output of the grade that is within the 70 to 60 range. It is D. That means satisfactory. So just print this one. Satisfactory. Right? Now the another one is within 60 to 50 range. We can again have another else if block and we can write less than 60 and 60 and greater than 50. So this belongs to grade E and the remark is work hard. And the another one will be this one. That means marks is less than 50 but it is greater than is equals to 40. So this would be within the grade F and F has a remark just passed, right? And then there is obviously the last one which doesn't sound really good, right? So we should not be within this category and we should always work hard to achieve some other grade rather than this. So in this case what you can do is, since this is the last condition, so you can always write else and you don't require if at this place. If you want, only the else will work because this is the only condition which is left. If the marks does not belong to any one of these blocks, then definitely it is going to be within the last if statement. Or if you want, you can give that condition and then you can have another else block where you can give output as the marks entered does not belong to any grade. So that can be done. For now just keep it simple and have this one as grade is not defined. You can simply write failed and then you can say sorry, work hard next time, right? This is where our code has already been written. Now if we execute this, we will see how we are getting this output and then we will also explain what exactly is happening. Let's run this. Now it asks you to enter the marks. So this time let's enter 90. So if it is 90, then what will happen is when you are entering 90 here, it accepts the marks 90 and assigns it to this variable marks, and then we are going to use that mark within the if conditions. Here what is happening is it will check marks is greater than equals to 90. So when it will check marks is greater than 90, it does not satisfy. But when it checks marks is equals to 90, then it definitely satisfies this if condition and thus it will execute this body. So if you press enter now, you will see that grade A excellent would be printed on the screen because it satisfied one of the criteria and thus this block got executed and our code ended. So we do not have to go to other else if blocks to check for the conditions because our condition has already got satisfied in the very first if block. Now let's execute again with different value. Now let's have a value of around 88. Where do you think this 88 would satisfy the condition? So this time when the marks is 88, it will check here 88 greater than is equals to 90. So 88 is definitely not greater than 90 and it is definitely not is equals to 90. So this block does not satisfy. Now it will come to this one. Else if 88 less than 90, okay, this is satisfied. That means it is correct. But just this condition is correct does not mean that this body will get executed because we have AND condition and within AND condition it should satisfy both the criteria, then only this will get executed. So we have already got one criteria satisfied. That means 50% evaluation is done and there is a 50% chance that this block gets executed if the next condition is also satisfied. So next condition is 88 is greater than is equals to 80. So does it satisfy? That means 88 is greater than 80, right? So it definitely satisfies. So we do not have to check for 88 is is equals to 80 is not needed, so it satisfied for this one. 88 is greater than 80 has been satisfied. That means both the conditions resulted in true. This one resulted in true and this one also resulted in true. And when true is applied with this AND operator, then true true will always give the evaluation of overall condition as true. And if this overall becomes true, then this block is going to get executed. That means this time our block grade B very good would be printed. So let's give an enter and see whether it gets printed or not. See, it is grade B very good. This is how the whole code would work. Now you can easily understand that how each and every code will get evaluated. We will just execute for one more value and then we'll leave you to try for the other values so that you can run and understand the code on your own. So this time let's have the marks as 33, which we definitely don't want to see in our report card, but for understanding let's have 33. Now your marks would be 33. Once you press enter, this marks is stored over here and then 33 will be checked. 33 greater than is equals to 90, definitely not, so this is not going to get executed. Then 33 is less than 90, okay, it satisfied. But this time 33 is greater than is equals to 80, no, 33 is never greater than or equals to 80, so this will also not get executed. This time 33 is less than 80, yeah, definitely it is, so this results in true. But when we come over here, 33 is greater than equals to 70, no, this is false, so the true and false will result in false because we have AND condition over here. If we used OR condition instead of AND condition, if we used this one, then it would have resulted in true because OR checks for any one to be true. If this is true or this is true, it gets satisfied for the OR. But if we have AND, then both the condition must be true, otherwise the block will not get executed. And that is why this 33 does not satisfy the second criteria due to which this will not get executed. Now it comes over here and again 33 less than 70 is true, this results in true. But this 33 greater than is equals to 60 does not result in true, and that is why this will also not get executed. And so on, it will check till here and we will see that only one of the condition where less than is applied is true, but the greater than 40 or greater than 50 is not getting satisfied and it results in false. So overall evaluation for true and false results in overall false in the if condition. As a result, the blocks does not get executed, and as a result we are at the end of the if else ladder, and then there is no other solution but to print this else block where it says that okay, you failed. So if you press enter, this says failed, sorry, work hard next time. So this is how this code is working. But have you noticed there is one flaw in this entire logic, and I would want you to correct that. For example, if you enter the mark greater than 100, so let's have a marks greater than 100, 110. Do you think out of 100 someone can get 110? Definitely not. So you should have one more condition where if the marks is entered to be more than 100, you should give a proper message that please enter the marks within the range of 0 to 100. So this is your task. Hope you have enjoyed this tutorial. If you have any question, please write it in the comment section. We will definitely love to answer your question. At the same time, thanks for being with us till the end of the video. Please like and subscribe to help us motivate.